Hey everybody on YouTube, Karl Alexander here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Firewatch. Let's get into it. And before we get started, I just want to give a shout out to my friend Johnny for hooking me up with this game. Thanks, buddy. Firewatch is a first-person, story-driven adventure game released on February 9th, 2016 for PlayStation 4, macOS, Linux, and Windows. Developed by Campo Santo and published by Panic, this was both companies' first title. Probably the most notable and talked about feature of Firewatch are the visuals, and they don't disappoint. This game really shows off what the Unity game engine can do if handled correctly. The colors are vibrant, the lighting is picturesque, and the art direction is wonderful. The art comes off as slightly comic-inspired, but still has a realistic aesthetic. It's like a stylized memory of the 1980s. The skylines are my favorite part of the visuals. Most games, the distant mountains look like shit because of poor LOD, but the simplicity of the geometry makes Firewatch's sunsets and sunrises something inspiring to look at. The soundtrack by Chris Remo is close to perfection. Music isn't always playing, but when it is, the mood is spot on. No track will really stick with you, but that's okay. The music fits so well that it just blends in with the entire experience. A soundtrack can completely change the tone of the game, and this definitely applies to Firewatch. It pushes the story forward and highlights the emotions of the characters. Performance is where some problems do show. For the most part, the game runs really smooth at high settings, but no matter what settings I used, there was a lot of odd animation jitter and periodic stuttering. I played around with my settings for quite a while, only to figure out that the frame dips and jitters are very common and have nothing to do with my settings. It's just poor engine optimization. None of these hiccups are game-breaking, but for such a short, story-driven game, it feels like the developer could have done a better job with QA. Gameplay is like any other walking simulator, meaning there isn't much of any. The only thing you really do in the game is explore the area around your fire tower by using a map and compass. At times, you'll need to pick up items and rappel down hills, but this all just amounts to simple mouse clicks and button presses. The main gameplay element is your dialogue selections. During your conversations with your supervisor, you can pick what to say or what not to say. These options won't have a profound impact on the outcome of the story, but they do offer some different ways of approaching a subject, and provide a look into how we ourselves choose what to say and what not to say. The streamlined, simple gameplay fits Firewatch well. It's about the story and setting, not about survival or inventory management. However, there is one optional gameplay element I really enjoyed. Early on, you find a disposable camera that you can use to take pictures. The photos are effectively screenshots that are shown at the end of the game. The limited amount of pictures brought me back to the days of taking pictures on school trips and making each shot count. The camera itself has a connection to the story, making it a nice addition that highlights the beauty of the game world and adds a bit of immersion. And at least at the time of this review, you can even order a set of physical prints of your pictures for $15. The great image quality and classic photo lab packaging made getting this in the mail so cool. It adds a real-world connection to the game, and its impact actually surprised me. It's just like getting your pictures back after a trip. There's a feeling of almost immediate nostalgia. It's definitely a gimmick, but it's also definitely a good one. As far as the story goes, Firewatch takes place in 1989 after the Yellowstone fires of 1988. You play as Henry, a man in his 40s who is starting his first stint as a fire lookout in the Shoshone National Forest. The fire tower is a two-day hike from civilization, and as you might assume, the job is to spot and report on fires in the area. Your supervisor Delilah operates a tower to the north and instructs you on how to do your job through a walkie-talkie. The interaction between Henry and Delilah makes up the entirety of the narrative. It's an interesting dynamic that really surprised me. Hearing Henry and Delilah talk is natural, funny, and sometimes even awkward.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. And people come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay. I get it.
The writing and voice acting are some of the best I've experienced in a game. Dialogue is realistic, and so are the characters. This isn't a big epic story with tons of twists and turns. It's a subdued story about how we as people deal with change, how we deal with pain and loss. Some have criticized the game's length and ending, and while I do wish the game had been about an hour or so longer, the ending is what it needed to be. Not every ending will be happy, and not every ending will tie everything up in a nice little bow. Video games are usually about exotic places and people in mortal danger, but Firewatch takes us on a journey that is grounded in reality. As with anyone's life, there are rarely dramatic endings to our stories. Real people don't walk off into the sunset or jump into each other's arms. I appreciate the lack of over-the-top drama. The game tells a story and tells it well. I think what the game leaves you with is perfect for what it is. A simple story about two people connecting when they couldn't connect to anyone else. Firewatch was an absolute joy to play. I had no expectations when I went into it, and I was pleasantly surprised by the craftsmanship of its story, characters, and setting. The game has some technical hiccups and is only 3 hours long, but for what it is, it's fantastic. Loss and connection are powerful emotional tools in a narrative, and they can be delicate to work with. Firewatch threads the needle with one of my favorite video game character dynamics yet. If you're looking for a game that does things differently and offers a new perspective on what games can be, go get Firewatch. Take a few hours out of your weekend and play it in one sitting. It's worth it. Okay, everybody, that was my video for this week. I hoped you liked it. If you did, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, I think you know what to do. Leave me a comment in the comments section and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this one in the future. Coming up next week, I'm going to have a video on the GTX 1070. It should be coming in this week. I'm going to do some benchmarks, see how the performance is on my system, and it should be pretty fun. I hope you join me for that one. I'll see you then.